Introduction from The Evolution of Sex by Matrakio Seldi, MPD. Published 2153 by the San Angeles Institute for Erotics. Everyone enjoys sex. That is not to say everyone enjoys having sex with another person or going through the social rituals to procure it. And there are still those who go through emotional torture as a result of the contradiction between their belief system and the facts of sexual psychology. Rather, it would be true to claim that everyone can take pleasure from the bodily sensations of sexual stimulation, as opposed to the presence of another human body giving those sensations. For some, the distinction is a subtle one, but the industries of sex toys, dildonics, and interactive pornography depend on it completely. Arguably, even prostitution is a business model dependent on the client's desire to replace a human being with a mind, desires, and agendas, with a responsive body which they can pretend has no thoughts of its own not related to the client's desire. Even today, prostitution still exists, and its practitioners may not care to liken themselves to the blow-up dolls of our grandparents. But this author is certain they can understand the characterization. In any case, this publication is concerned with recent advents in wholly artificial stimulation devices and with research conducted by the San Angeles Institute for Erotics and its sponsor, the Bodyplex Corporation. There is no reason why the mechanical devices and methods used to auto-stimulate should resemble the biological organs and methods a human can provide. The placement of the clitoris, for example, is not convenient for stimulation by a penis. The prostate is easier to reach, but neither penises nor fingers can provide the rapid sensations of a vibrator. This is why the most effective clitoral stimulators look nothing like any bodily organ. And the modern penile oral stimulator has up to 5 tongues, each concentrating on different sub-erogenous zones. In the following sections, a variety of authors working in various fields will detail their recent work and put it into historical context. The first section deals with a number of still common misconceptions, especially that stimulation is a way to get to orgasm as quickly as possible. Methods for this do exist, but actually the majority of research does not concern orgasms at all, neither advancing nor delaying them, not extending them, making them multiple, or decreasing the refractory period before the next one. Indeed, only a minority of nerve clusters classified as erotic are involved in orgasm production at all. The scrotum or outer vagina, the buttocks, perineum and inner thighs, the anus and rectum, the nipples and indeed the face are all sensitive areas capable of stimulation. Furthermore, when we speak of stimulation, we do not just mean the common wet licking, dry sucking, rolling, massaging and pulling variations. We are also referring to sensations that would be called painful in another context. Pinching, pinpoint heat, rough friction, and so on. The second section expands on this, detailing development of the latest full-body sex suits. With these, all the common pleasure centers, plus most of the uncommon ones, can be simultaneously stimulated. The mouth, for instance, is filled with a wide, slightly spongy mass which pulses and provides waves of warmth traveling along its length, and which tapers at the vellum to bypass the gag reflex, then expands again to push against the throat, optionally extending down as far as the stomach opening. The lips, however, require a completely different stimulant, distantly related to a kiss. It involves massaging the lips with soft rollers which release a viscous oil that serves a secondary purpose for the olfactory sense. The nipples are alternately spiked and soothed, as are the thighs. The rectum is filled with a balloon-like structure with rounded studs, inflating and deflating every few seconds to create a kind of breathing internal pressure. Many users enjoy rectal stimulation, but not the sensation of the anus being transversely stretched, so the tube going into the rectum can be made small. Thus, it is possible to have the feeling of a penis or a fist in the rectum, without the inconvenience of one passing through the anus. These and other innovations are discussed, with the focus on the development process, marketing, empirical research, hormone theory, and ethical issues are also touched upon. The third and final section deals with expanded sensation methods, which show great promise but are still in early stages. The human brain contains a map of the body, continuously updated by sensory feedback. However, sometimes the map or the update system misfunction, leading to alien limb syndrome, phantom limb syndrome in amputees, and the rare conditions where the brain thinks the body has an extra, invisible part. It was this last condition which led a team of SAIE researchers to speculate that the brain could be electromanipulated to create new body parts existing only in the body map, complete with sensory feedback, erogenous zones, and unique kinds of stimulation. After 10 years of experimentation, it is now possible to generate and remove multiple illusory organs in minutes, with a range of pleasurable sensations not possible in the physical body. Needless to say, this is tremendously exciting work, and we look forward to future refinements. We have come a long way since the days when the only way to gain erotic pleasure was in sharing it with another. That way still exists, and humans being the social creatures they are, is in no danger of dying out. But with technology, the possibilities are now so much greater.